to tell this story a little different than I usually tell it. This is this song was written about, really about the second movie from the Twilight Saga, which I saw one night in Melbourne, Australia, when I was on the road with Fleetwood Mac in 2009. Story builds up to that in this way. 2001, I did a record called Trouble in Shangri-La, and it ended up to be very much trouble in Shangri-La. And the internet exploded, and I was so like hurt by the fact that music was not going to be bought anymore. It was just going to be found in the cloud, and I just didn't like it. And so I really, for all practical purposes, walked away from the recording world of music for 9 years until I went to Brisbane and saw this movie. And what this movie did for me, and I'm sure that you can, most of you will be able to relate. I laid in bed thinking about this last night. It's like that love affair between Bella and Edward. If you have had that, then you understand it. And maybe you don't have it now, but I try to bring this to you in order to bring you back to that moment. And if you haven't had it, I try to take hold of you and bring you in to let you experience it. Because really, there's nothing like a tragic love affair. So Moonlight was the reason that I started to record again and that I started to write songs again. When I finished the song, I went to my little assistant who was hiding around the corner. I said, okay, I'm done. I'm ready to make a record now because I have to now write songs to put their arms around Moonlight so that I can release it as a record. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go home and make a record. And that's what I did. And I went home and made In Your Dreams in 2010. So, anyway, it's my favorite song I've ever written. And it's my favorite song to perform. I'm glad you like it. And so thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Very short story. Prince and I were friends, and he wrote a song called Little Red Corvette, and I had a poem, and I sang the poem over his song, and I called him from Sunset Sound Recording Studios in Los Angeles and said, can you come over? Because I have this song that I wrote to your song. And he said, I'll be right there. And he was right there in 15 minutes. And he came in and the track was done, more or less. And he did the do-do-do-do-do-do things on the organ part. And then he did some guitar. And he did a few other things. And he was happy, he loved it, and he was gone. In a purple haze. And that's exactly how he was. He came into your life and he would be out of your life before you even realized that he was even in your life. So I'm gonna miss him. And the fact is though, is that whenever we hear Stand Back, whenever you hear it in the radio, whenever I hear it, you can just click it right into Little Red Corvette. They are one and the same. And feel blessed that we have that little connection that was made, because he was really spectacular. So that's all I So this next song, that's coming.
It's Little Girl Over Here.
Not that I can see you, because I can't see a thing. So I'm going to now, we're going to play for you, when I finish my story, the oldest song that we have ever played on stage. It's from the Hunting of the Next album. And you already know a little bit about this, but when Lindsay and I drove to Los Angeles in 1971, we moved in with my producer, our producer, and then we met Waddy through our producer. And Waddy already had a job. He was a really well-known session player, and he already had a job. We had no job. So we just played music. We sat around and we played music, and looking back on it, it was like, people say like it's the time of your life. Well, it was the time of our life. And anyway, we had the Buckingham Nicks songs when we got to LA demoed. So we proceeded to really record them in a big studio called Sound City, also a famous place. Yes, and so that's what we did for like forever, for a couple years. And there was a song that we all knew was gonna be the single. Now, the record really didn't go out. It did, and a few of you have it, but it got dropped in like 2 months. And nobody, you know, we weren't that aware that it was out. So, but this song was supposed to be the single. And, but we never played it. We never, after that, I mean, the record, we went and joined Fleetwood Mac, and then we never played this song again, ever. And over the years, Waddy has said to me many times, why don't we do this song? And I would be like, I don't know, maybe we shouldn't do it. Is it ours? I mean, can we? And finally, this time when we went into rehearsal, he said, I really think we should do this song. I don't think that we don't have a lot of time, but something like that. And I said, okay, let's do it. So anyway, this is a song about a very intriguing woman who I had no idea who I was writing about, because I was only like 22. So anyway, here it is. It's called Crying in the Night.
She's a girl.
So this is the last thing I'm gonna say about this song. And this is like, because this is like a testament to dreams coming true. We moved here in, not here, but to Los Angeles in 1971. I think I wrote the song before we left San Francisco, so that would have been 1970. But let's just round it off and say I left there, I wrote it in 1973 when the record came out. That would be 1973, 1983, 1993, 2003, 2013, 14, 15, 16. 43 years ago. So this is my thought for you for tonight. The testament is, dreams do come true. Anything you want is out there for you to just reach out there in the stars of Belladonna and grab one. Because it is all there. This song has not been done for 43 years. And we're doing it at Madison Square Garden tonight. And there's the record right there, looking at me. That picture got me in so much trouble with my parents. You have no idea. I said to my dad, I didn't want to do it. And my father goes, well, why didn't you just say no? And I said, because they said to me, don't be a child, it's art. Anyway, you must continue to believe that you can have what you want. Don't let anybody tell you you're not talented enough or smart enough or any of that like stuff. Because you are. You're totally beautiful, you're totally talented, you can do anything you want. And never let anybody get in your way. Tell them to get out of your way. You're on your way.